simulation is used as a key piece of our experiential education model. What we're able to do by combining online learning and simulation experiences is to give students that really intense, high-quality, human-to-human interaction as if it's a real patient. They'll develop their knowledge and critical thinking skills through online learning, but it's when they get to the simulation center that they have that real-world interaction with the real people. All of our simulations start in our briefing rooms. These spaces are where students are presented with their initial case. It's a quiet place for them to kind of initially process the information. In addition to the briefing space and the labs, the sims are produced in our control rooms. Our control rooms are where our faculty and our sim staff control the simulators. We may voice or communicate with the patients. We control the AV capture system to assure that they have a good recording of their experiences. Today's simulation focuses on several key nursing skills. They will have to assess the patient, identify important signs and symptoms related to their pathology and their condition.
Head the bed down. Breathing, doing good. We're going to get you some oxygen going. Massage that fundus. Make it go back down to where it was before.
They'll have to act on that information in a way that improves patient care, including making decisions about what's best for that patient. One of probably the most critical pieces of simulation is the reflection. The debrief can either make or break an experience for a student. It's not unusual for students to be upset after a simulation or concerned about whether they did things right. And it's really in the context of debriefing where the students will talk and meet with the trained debriefer to bring this experience in life. It is really why we wake up every day to do this, to have a student at the end of the simulation say, "That was awesome. I want to do this again."